This video demonstrates the REMM, Radiation Emergency Medical Management, website's updated interactive tool for managing the subsyndromes of the acute radiation syndrome, ARS, after exposure to whole body radiation. This update was introduced on REMM in March 2014. This tool is now easier to use and provides more content than the previous version on REMM. On this start page, I first read the clinical caution statements about the need to individualize care for patients exposed to radiation. I also note that during extreme austerity conditions, some therapies and medical facilities suggested by this tool may not always be readily available. Then I click each of the four main ARS subsyndromes, hematopoietic, H, gastrointestinal, G, cutaneous, C, and neurovascular, N. Within each subsyndrome, see the list of specific groups of signs and symptoms or clinical parameters associated with that particular subsyndrome. Note that each individual parameter is associated with a drop-down menu that allows me to pick one of four increasing levels of severity that could describe that parameter. A clinician can work through one or all four of the subsyndromes and assign a level of severity to as many parameters as possible for each subsyndrome. Let's work through a hypothetical example of one patient. For the hematopoietic subsyndrome, I select the following severities. Note that all values are for 10 to the 9th cells or cellular elements per liter. Absolute lymphocyte count of 1 to as low as 0.5, which is degree 3. Absolute neutrophil count of 1 to 0.5, degree 3. Platelet count of 100 to 50, degree 2. And no blood loss, degree 0. Then I click View Treatments to Consider and note two results. First, an overall severity score of hematopoietic or H3 has been assigned because 3 is the highest severity level for any of the individual parameters in this subsyndrome. Second, the check boxes below suggest the kinds of treatments or further evaluations that might be considered based on the inputs I entered on the prior screen. These are suggestions only, not requirements. I can print this suggestion page if I wish. Clicking the X at the top right closes the screen, but the information is carried over to the next screen unless I click Start Over. Now let's carry over the previous H information and go on to the next subsyndrome, neurovascular, N. I click Nausea Severity 4, Vomiting Severity 3, and Blood Pressure Severity 4. I then click View Treatments to Consider. I did this even though I did not select each and every element in this subsyndrome. I see the N4 score, print the suggestions, close the screen, and then click View Response Category, RC. RC is auto-calculated using the highest degree of severity checked for any parameter in any of the four subsyndromes of ARS that were evaluated. The more data entered, the more useful is the RC score and clinical suggestions. For the hypothetical case we worked through, the severity was H3 and N4, resulting in an RC value of 4. RC is one way of linking a patient's clinical severity with the venue where a clinician might wish to send the patient for appropriate care. Detailed information about the RC strategy is presented in the far right column of each of the four RC rows. This tool is based on the European Metropole system, medical treatment protocols, which has evolved over many years. Original and subsequent key references are available as hyperlinks on this page. There is one final caution about using this tool. Be sure to click Start Over between patients in order to erase all previously entered data. This completes our video introducing REMM's interactive tool for managing the subsyndromes of ARS.